Saturday night at Chiemsee Reggae Summer 2010. I'm here with Jamieson. Greetings to you.
Greetings to you also.
We just enjoy your really nice performance. I saw people dancing in t-shirt. I mean, you're really spreading the fire.
Yeah, you don't know. It's all about love and togetherness and, you know, positive vibes and, you know, staying focused, you know, and sharing what's good for me to let someone know it's good for them too, especially when I say, grow your own food, be self-sufficient, because in this time, it's for real what I'm saying. Babylon wants to control, and they control by food, by us depending, you know what I'm saying, and not being independent. So, what I'm really trying to, the message I'm trying to send across, especially now, with the positive vibes is, you know, grow your own food and be self-sufficient and grow your own herbs and, you know, things will be more, life will be much easier.
Well, you definitely left a positive message, but what I would like to ask you is, what are you getting back from seeing the crowd enjoying your music like that? What do you get back?
Well, a Jah give all reward, you know, we leave all that to him, but it's all about togetherness. It's not what I'm getting back, it's what we are getting back. It's not me alone enjoying it, the people enjoying it, so me reacting with the crowd, it's us getting this music together as one, and you know what I'm saying, using music to transport the message to the world, you know, so a fan can tell someone who never came tomorrow what I was really reaching and the point where I was trying to get to. Yeah.
I just asked you, Bridget Fantan, about Tour Life, right? Because we normal people, we imagine Tour Life to be so nice. You know, you wake up in different cities every morning, you know, and... But
to be honest with you,
is there other side of it?
Well, I'm telling you the side of it that I know. I don't know about the other side. It's just one side.
How do you experience it? Is it always that easy, for example, to, you know, the different climate changes, the different time zones? I think it's taken a lot of energy out of the body, right?
Well, it's, put it like this. It's like, you know, you have a job and you have to wake up 8 o'clock in the morning to go to work. And if you don't go to work, your boss will fire you, all right? So it's like, me have a job and my employer is Haile Selassie. Seeing Haile Selassie is my boss. So me, I have to keep on doing my job, whether rain or shine, or even when you're sick, you got to still do your job. That's when, you know, the reward is greater, because you still put out that effort. Even when you have the last moment, you still should put out that effort.
Yeah.
So it's all about getting to the point, the never give up stage. You know, so it's a duty I and I have to carry out. And I have to carry out my duty and make sure I do what's right and don't make any mistake.
Going back in time now, how can we imagine it? Was there a point in your life where you just decided, hey, I want to go into music, I want to spread the message, or did you grow into it?
Well, actually, yeah, I grew into music because my family and, you know, they were singing and it was all music around us. You know about Jamaica, we grow up hearing music. So it's actually, it's what you see around you every day and hear. You adapt these principles, whether good or bad principles. That's what a child growing up, whatever the surrounding is within the environment, it's totally gonna be adapted, you know? Yeah, it's just like if you grow up with Spanish people, all Spanish people in the house, and you speak English, you're gonna know some Spanish.
A lot of your songs surrounding the topic, true love, right? Do you think it's important, once you find your true love, to really fight for it, and to really, I wouldn't say fight, but to really try to keep it, try to maintain?
Well, when I say true love, I mean love with the truth, you know, in general. You understand me, loving people and caring, and the infant being cared for, homeless shelter, you understand me? Because I and I as Bubba Shanti is for the poor and have not. That's why we say self-sufficiency, you know, and showing people how we can generate and create for our own. For example, the Bobo Shanti, we make floor mats in Jamaica and brooms. And cleanliness, it's all about cleanliness. Broom is for keeping the place clean and the floor mat is for don't go in the house with the dirty shoes. You understand me? So it's cleanliness is next to godliness. Man of right is God. Man of wrong is Satan. So I and I just keep it real. And I don't want to like judge people with other people mistake. Or from other people mistake. For instance, someone make a mistake, I don't want to say you're going to do the same thing. No, we don't do that. You know, we just keep it real and let nature takes its course. You know, as all you have to do is just be positive.
You definitely have a very clean and positive spirit, and I thank you very much for that interview.